Good morning, children.
I'm your social science teacher. Today, let us start with the lesson agriculture, children. See, children, when I ask you all, did you all have food? You will say, yes, ma'am, we had breakfast, we had lunch, we had dinner. Did you drink milk? Yes, ma'am, we drank milk, we drank coffee, we drank tea. You will say different types of foods, children. Did you at least one day think that who has provided all this to us? So, from where did we get this? If you would have thought, it will come from the lesson agriculture. See, children, without agriculture in the world, people will not get food to eat. So, today we are going to study about how the growth of agriculture it took place and what are the factors influencing agriculture, types of farming we are going to study, children, today. See, children, when I say, I'll give you one small exercise like this. See here, put a tick on the items which are made from crops. If I say shirt, toothbrush, bread, milk powder, apple sack, noodles, then jute sack, tea, laptop. See, children, why I'm giving this is brainstorming, children. Brainstorming exercise this is called as. See, shirt. Yes. From crops. From cotton. Yes, it is. Toothbrush, plastic. No. Bread. Yes. Milk powder. No. Apple sack. No. Noodles. Yes. Jute sack? No. Jute sack? Yes, children. Apple sack also. Because jute is also a crop. Tea? Yes. Laptop? No. So, this is how you are going to experience every day in your life which is brought from the crop and which is not brought from the crops. Okay. So, this is a brainstorming exercise I have done for you all. So, now next, let us move on to the topic agriculture, children. See, when I say agriculture, it is the growth of crops for direct human consumption. Human being is consuming the crops which is directly brought from the fields. Okay. The term agriculture has been derived from the Latin words agar and cultura. See, from the Latin word agar and cultura. Okay. So, which means cultivation. Understand, children? In this chapter, let us study the growth of agriculture, factors that influence agriculture in a place and the types of farming practiced all over the world, children. Today we are going to study about this in our lesson. Okay, children. So, finally, you may be thinking what ma'am is telling. She did a brainstorming exercise and now she started teaching us. So, children, let us study about the growth of agriculture as I told you. See, people are involved in a number of economic activities like primary, secondary and tertiary, children. These are the three main: primary, secondary and tertiary, children. See, primary is agriculture. Secondary is industries. Third one, tertiary is, can anybody tell? It is nothing but vehicles, transportation. So here, you see children, it is interlinked to one another. See, when I say primary, agriculture, when the farmer grows, rice, wheat, ragi, etc., when he is growing, he has to take it to the industries to make, if he is growing paddy, sorry, when he is growing paddy, he has to make it rice. So what he'll do? He has to remove the husk. So he has to take it to the mill. That is to the rice mill he has to take. So that is secondary children. And when it is ready over there, again he has to carry it back to his village or to his house. So he needs transportation there. So everything is interlinked with one another, children, here. And so agriculture is a primary activity. It is defined as the art and science of cultivating the soil and growing crops. And it also includes rearing of livestock, children. What is the meaning of livestock? Rearing of livestock, when I say it, it is nothing but cattle, which you keep sometimes in the farm. Along with our agriculture work, we keep even the livestock and we take care of it. Like goat, sheep, cow, buffaloes, all this we keep it. So activities where raw materials are processed and converted into finished products are called as secondary children here. And then, for example, jute fiber is used for making jute bags. Tertiary activities are those activities which provide service to the primary and to the secondary. As I told you, it is interlinked with one another. And so, for example, transport, communication, banking and insurance, all these come under tertiary sector, children. So, over the years, it has been improved. Methods and technologies have been implemented. Great progress has been made in all aspects of crop production, children. How it changes for better have been introduced in ploughing, sowing, irrigation, weeding and harvesting. See here, first one, it is ploughing, sowing, irrigation, weeding, finally, it will be harvesting. So, these are the main for the agriculture, children. First, you will have to plough the field. After ploughing the field, we are going to sow the seeds. Then we will start irrigation. And then we will remove the weeds. Unwanted plants is called as weeding. Removing the unwanted plants. Okay. And then, and finally, when the crop is ready, we harvest it. So, ploughing, sowing, irrigation, weeding and harvesting, children, takes place in agriculture. And presently 50% of the world population is directly or indirectly engaged in agriculture. More than 50% of the people are directly or indirectly, they are involved in this agriculture field, children. In India today, 52% of the population practices agriculture for a living. 52% of people practice agriculture for a living, children. So the next topic is about factors influencing agriculture. Factors influencing agriculture. So what are the factors? Here is, there are two types of factors. One is physical factor
physical factor, and the next one is socio-economic factor.
So there are two types of factors. One is physical factor and the other one is socio-economic factors, children. So here, the techniques of farming, types of crops cultivated and the quantities of crops produced vary from region to region. See, in every area, it cannot be the same crop growing because the nutrients in the soil will differ. This we have studied in the natural land, soil and water we have studied, children, in the previous topics. So it will vary from region to region. Such variations is due to the following factors. That is due to physical factor and socio-economic factor. See, children, physical factors, which includes the environmental factors like climate, relief and soil. In socio-economic factors, it includes human factors such as labor, capital, technology and market. See, children, here it needs climate, relief and soil, okay, and here it needs labor, capital, technology and marketing, okay. See, children, for physical factor, first there should be a perfect climatic condition should be there to grow certain crops. In certain climate they will be growing. Relief factor, rain should be there. And water, rain, everything should be there. And soil nutrients also should be there. Then in socio-economic factor, it is labor, capital, technology and market, children. So when I say types of farming, the next one is under this types of farming we have, children. That is subsistence farming and commercial farming. See, there are two types again here, like two factors, two types of farming we have here, children. See, farming is done in various ways across the world. On the basis of geographical conditions like labor, level of technologies may be different. See, when I say technology, in America, a farmer will wear suit and he will go in the car to the field and he will cultivate the crops. Whereas an Indian farmer, he will be only with his dhoti and with a towel. You think of the clothes difference only, children. So it is different in different countries. So here, the level of technology also is different. Here we use plowing. Nowadays we have technology is being improved. We have got little bit machineries we have got for growing crops. Earlier, the farmer used to plow, pull the water. So all this, now we have got tube wells. He used to, with the tubes, they used to pull the water out. Now we have got bore wells, pump sets, etc. So there are two main types of farming, that is subsistence farming and commercial farming. See, children, when I say subsistence farming, again under subsistence farming you will have different types of farming will be there. Now I tell you what is subsistence farming. It is practiced mostly in tropical lowlands. It is being practiced, children. Here the farmers grow crops mainly for their family's consumption only. Only for their family he will grow the crops. The farm sizes are very small. And he will use primitive methods of farming. That is primitive tools he will use. And then family members help in the farms. He will not hire anybody to plow the field over their children. So subsistence farming can further be classified into primitive subsistence farming and intensive subsistence farming. That next class I will be teaching you, children. So here again it will be primitive and intensive.
next class I'll be teaching you all children. So did you all understand children? Agriculture is nothing but agri and culture, that is soil and cultivation. So we have three types mainly: primary, secondary and tertiary, and they are interdependent on one another. And the next one is factors influencing agriculture, that is physical factor, socio-economic factor. When I say physical factor, it's climate, relief and soil. Socio-economic factor, it is labor, capital, technology and market, children. And next is types of farming, that is subsistence farming and commercial farming. Under subsistence farming, the farmer grows crops only to his family, not for marketing, okay? And his family members only will be helping him in the farm, and he will not hire any laborers over there, and he will use primitive tools only, children. So this is about subsistence farming. Under subsistence farming, we have got primitive subsistence and intensive subsistence we have got. That I'll be continuing in the next class. Thank you all, children. Have a nice day. There is a few question and answers given and a small worksheet will be given. Please work it out. Thank you all, children.